Welcome back to the final tip for Tuesday of the month of June. And man, it is hot outside. But, and hopefully you guys are getting some hot deals and talking with some sellers. But this is Ronnie with Simple Wholesaling and Mr. Brian Snyder. So today what we guys want to talk about is going and digging deeper. I know you guys been out there on the pavement. You've been hitting, talking with these sellers. And sometimes like, man, I want to get out of the sun and just, you know, pretty surface with some of the questions. But I'm telling you, there is money and value in digging deeper. We've been doing some trainings, been talking deeper, and I've been talking a lot deeper, asking more in-depth, personal, hard, confrontational questions to sellers in order to get that information in the build rapport. Brian, what are your thoughts on digging deeper and asking deeper questions to sellers?
Well, I love it. This is like right in my wheelhouse. So I'm a former teacher, if you didn't know that about me. But one of the things that made me a successful teacher was that I really focused on digging deeper and asking. I would drive my students crazy with the questions I would ask. And one of the main questions I would ask is just why. As a math teacher, when they came up with when they got an answer to a problem, they would ask me if it's right. I'd say, I don't know. Is it? How did you get that? Why did you get that? Those types of things. Just asking deeper. It's the same thing when you're talking to sellers, going deep into what is really going on. So I'm not saying you have to sit down. Your first question you're going to ask them is like, tell me your whole life story. It's nothing like that. But as you build rapport, as you're learning more about their properties, you're learning more about their house, you're talking to them. You're figuring out like, oh, okay, yeah, this bedroom, like, oh, you know, blue is a great color. Like, why did you pick blue? Just even little questions about that and figuring out kind of what's going on, asking as many questions as you can, as long as that conversation just keeps going, but asking deeper questions too, to get to the surface on like really what their issue is, what's happening, why they need to sell that property, what's really going on. Is it a money issue? Is it a house issue? Is it just a personal issue? Whatever it may be. But then also what's going to stand in the way of that? What reservations do they have? What deal killers are involved? Are they talking to anybody else? Are they really the person that is the decision maker? Mm-hmm. All those things, start by asking those little questions about the house, about, you know, little rapport building things, but then just getting deeper and deeper. I know one of the things I like to do too, when I actually am moving into that, like, hey, this is a deeper part of the conversation. If I'm on the phone, I'm going to change my tone of voice. I'm going to say, hey, I'm gonna ask you a couple, you know, some a little bit more in depth questions if you don't mind, if you have the time, those types of things. If I'm in person, if I'm at their house, you know, with a seller, I'm gonna say, hey, do you mind if we sit down somewhere, you know, so we can have kind of a, you know, a little bit more of a serious conversation? I'm gonna let them know that, like, hey, I'm about to go deeper, but I'm still gonna be friendly about it and everything like that. And then once they say yes, they're inviting you to ask those questions, and it's gonna be okay. But those are the questions that need to be asked and to go deeper with it, because that's what you're really figuring out is, what is their situation? Why are they selling? And what could possibly make this blow up or not allow us to get the deal? So I know Ronnie's a master of this. Ronnie does a great job with it, man. So what's some other things you do to kind of help yourself out with that?
I'm always asking, like, you know, Brian said, those springboard questions. And like he already mentioned, changing your tone of voice to make sure that they understand that, yes, we've had a great conversation, but let's get to the crux of things and the deeper and the why. So, you know, Brian already laid some great foundation, man. Continue to ask those how, what questions, and then also even asking, okay, now we've agreed to property, or agreed to price. How much time do we need to live to move out? You know, should we agree on price? Those are all different things, because every property that you're going to, you know, get under contract isn't necessarily going to be vacant. You know, they're going to need time to move around, and you might even need help with moving. So just asking questions that give you a better picture about the whole situation will definitely help, you know, even with your offer that you're making. So
so many times, Ronnie, I think we have this conversation all the time, and you can kind of maybe you can. I think we're going a little bit along here with this, but maybe you can give a little bit of advice on this too. So many times we see the property, we see the, you know, it's kind of the situation, what's going on. It always starts being about the price. That's what the person is calling you for, to get that price. Very, you know, maybe less than, I would say, maybe 20% of the time, it ends up being about the price. Most of the time it's about that situation. Agree with that? I mean, it's...
Yeah, no, it is literally always usually about the situation, because people either have a house problem, or usually there is a money problem, and they need to get rid of it. You know, I've run into situations where it's a, you know, someone called me, look, man, my girlfriend left me. I thought I was going to have her for the rest of my life. She made me sell all of my Coke products, you know, because he had a lot of Coke products. And he's like, I just wanted to sell my house and just get rid of it. You know, but, you know, if you wouldn't have known that, if you're just kind of just thinking about price, you want to get to know exactly what's going on. So you can summarize that when you're presenting your offer again. I want to help you get to X and B, whatever it is. So
deeper questioning.
Deeper questioning.
So awesome. We'll see you guys back next week. Later.